Hey there. It's been a while since we talked about any sort of personal organization because I really haven't had much to say. Things have been progressing as I had started, and since you saw in the last video, I'm still using this linear vertical setup where I just put the task for each day of the week inside them. On that day, I open it up, pull them out into now, or the ones that I'm actually going to try to do now. And as I complete them, I just mark them off and then I put them into my log. However, I do want to mention two things that have changed, and I think I'll make a video around at least one of these. Because I think it's worth mentioning. The first one is I've actually started to use the inbox more because I've started to use some of the tools that we have to actually capture information quickly into Workflowy. Even though they've always been there, I haven't really used them. I guess it just took a while for them to become a habit. And it's weird because I'm always with my phone, but I'm not always in front of my computer. However, I generally prefer to just type things out, open up the app, and put them in there. But I've actually started to use some speech-to-text software just generally as part of my day-to-day, both for work and for my personal writing. And so it's been really useful. And so it's gotten me into the habit of actually dictating things more. So I've started to use things like the shortcuts that we have to take voice notes and put those into the inbox. And that's been really useful because not only do they work on my phone, but they work on my watch when my phone's in my pocket or I'm driving. And I didn't realize how nice it is to be able to quickly capture these half-baked ideas or just thoughts that pop into my head that eventually could become like a video or an article or just something, whether it's for my work or for my personal life. It's just kind of nice to have it. And so I think it's worth mentioning all the different ways that you can do that, not just with the Apple shortcut, but there are a bunch of different ways depending on what your day actually looks like. So we'll definitely make a video on that. And then another thing that I did want to mention that has changed about this setup, because I think that might also be interesting just how I organize and do things. Is that recently Workflowy added the calendar slash today feature? It'll just open up a calendar with today's date based on whatever format you set. And so I thought that wouldn't really be that useful for me. I've just never really been the type to journal or write things every day. I do have some sort of a log. I just like to make note of what I've done, especially for my work, but also I do it in my personal life. I like to take notes of what did I do today or what did I say I was going to do today and how much of that did I actually accomplish. So I didn't think this was going to help me that much, but it's been really interesting. And the way that I'm actually using it is not to journal because, like I said, I don't really do that. But where it's come in really handy is it's helped me automate this logging process that I have. So now let's say that I record this next video. What I would normally do is I would open up the log and go into the month, drag and drop it there. And I can still do that. But now an easier way to do that is to use the slash command today. And there you go, move to today. So I just hit enter and it's archived it for me. Right where it's supposed to go. And I can even hit another keyboard shortcut to jump in there, add some additional notes or context or things like that. And so this is another way that I thought might be interesting to share. I would imagine most people probably like to start their day here. They just click on today, write out a plan, maybe add some notes or whatever it is, and use this kind of as their daily journal slash to-do list agenda thing. That's just not the way I work. But I found this way of using it really nice. One other thing that I also started using a lot more is the shortcuts. So all the custom shortcuts you can now do inside of Workflowy have been really nice. Previously, I just would use the jump to menu and quickly search, and that works too. But it's surprising to me how quickly you can develop the muscle memory to jump around with keyboard shortcuts. And I don't know, it just feels so much nicer. It's really starting to feel more like individual pages versus zooming in and zooming out. And so for me, at least, it's really starting to turn this whole daily organization and planning into something that just flows a lot better, especially being able to jump into different sections and add things and modify things and then quickly jump back. It just feels really nice. And I don't know, something I wanted to share. If you haven't been using any of the custom keyboard shortcuts you can set by just doing something like this, you go slash shortcut and then you set a keyboard shortcut. Now, I'm really sticking to one and two letter shortcuts just because that is the least amount you can write. And I find that those work really well. You don't need to go for an entire word because at that point you're basically just searching. But the whole point is that you can move across your account really quickly. If you combine it with any of the different systems that we've seen, if you've been watching any of the productivity videos or the personal knowledge management videos, you combine the shortcuts with those systems. And now you have a system where you can instantly jump to all those different sections, regardless of what productivity system you use. And Workflowy becomes this really hyper fast customized platform for whatever you want to do. And it's just been really nice. I already enjoyed Workflowy, obviously, but now it's just taken it to the next level for me. It feels closer like an application you might use for coding, like an IDE where things just kind of click together really well. the features really complement each other in a nice way to where you can set up a system. And no matter how you actually organize things or which productivity system you use, if you use any of those or a personal knowledge management system, you can combine shortcuts plus the quick capture plus the calendar. And you've got this system that just really works well. And I don't know, I just wanted to share a little bit of that. It's been interesting to me having used Workflowy for so many years and feeling like I already had a system that I enjoyed and was fine. It didn't really need any changes. And these features just clicked for me. And I wanted to share that because maybe it's something you'd like to try. And so, yeah, you can look forward to some of these new videos in the coming days and weeks. So that's it. Just wanted to give you a little update on and share some of the things that have me excited about organizing my life inside of Workflowy and just in general. So hopefully that was interesting, and I'll see you in the next one.